Good morning. Good morning for the second time. So I tried to record this video a few minutes ago, and for whatever reason, I did not have any sound. So now I deleted it and I decided to start over again. So you are seeing me twice for the day, but it's because of technical difficulties. Okay, so today, actually, I want to do it a little differently today. So I want to start with a little pop quiz for you. All right, so I'm going to call out five names and see if you can recognize any of those names. Okay, here they are: Virender Sehwag, Sachin Tendulkar, Rahul Dravid, Sourav Ganguly, Sunil Gavaskar. Do you remember? Do you? Can you identify any of these people? Well, if you are from India, you would definitely recognize them, especially if you are a fan of cricket. I came from the West Indies, the island of Dominica, and the cricket has been a big deal for us for a long time. Because both India and most of the islands of the West Indies, they share something in common, and that is we were a colony of Britain, and part of what we got from Britain is the game of cricket. So cricket is a big deal for us. In fact, I could remember growing up that one of the Calypsonians made a song based upon one of the matches that was going on. I think it was somewhere in the 1970s when India toured the West Indies for the first time, and actually India beat us in the West Indies. And this Calypsonian made this song. Here's a few lines of it. It says, "A lovely day for cricket, blue skies and gentle breeze. The Indians are awaiting now to play the West Indies. A signal from the umpire. The match is about to start. The cricketers come on the field. They all look very smart." And then the refrain says, "It was Gavaskar, the real master." Just like a wall, they couldn't out Gavaskar at all, not at all. The West Indies could not out Gavaskar at all in those days. The Indians, or the people of India cricket team, had a great batsman. His name was Sunil Gavaskar. And Sunil Gavaskar gave the West Indies a very hard time in that test series. So those five names that I called, actually I looked up on the internet, and it's a site that said the 20 of the most popular cricketers, or the 20 of the most notorious cricketers of India, 20 of the best cricketers of India, and those five names came up. And of course, I can never forget Sunil Gavaskar. Today, more recently, we think of Sachin Tendulkar, one of the greatest of the Indian batsmen. So, you ask me, so what's the big deal about India? Why you bring up India today? Well, the last 20 years or so, 18 years, 18 to 20 years, God has given me the opportunity to work with people that have come from all over the world, many, many different cultures. And that includes, of course, people from India, people from Burma. I have made lifelong friends from people that have come from India and the people that have come from Burma. But especially, I want to focus on those two countries today. Because of the what is going on currently, both of those countries, in India and in Burma, there is a lot of people there having a hard time, and I really want us to take a little time to pray for them. It has always been God's plan to reach men and women from every culture. If you look back in the book of Revelation chapter 5 and Revelation chapter 7, it tells us that it gives us a picture of the last days where a great multitude are gathered before the throne of God, giving praise unto the Lamb, the Lord Jesus Christ. And it says that it was men and women from every tribe and every culture and every tongue and every language. Every ethnicity is represented there, because it has always been God's plan to bring into his family people from everywhere. You see, God is no respecter of persons. God wants to see people come to repentance and people come to know Christ as their Savior. And God doesn't really care about ethnicity or color. You know, in fact, when God called Abraham, God said to Abraham, I will bless them that bless you, and I will curse those that curse you. And then he says, through you, all the nations, all the world will be blessed. And I happen to be one of those that are blessed. You happen to be one of those that are blessed because God sent his Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he is the one that brings salvation. He is the one that brings changes in people's lives. And for us as his people, he has called us to be salt and light. He has called us to love other people and to care about all people and to have compassion. In the world today is dividing people based on race and color and tribe and language. You know, God is calling on his people to be the salt and the light, to pray for everybody. And wherever we can, with the message of the gospel, give them the message of the gospel so that people's lives can be transformed. People's lives can be changed, so that just like us who are on our way to heaven, they themselves can be on their way to heaven. But it's not just a matter of giving them a ticket to heaven, but helping people to grow strong in their faith. Okay, so God's people, we have to be about building up and strengthening and allowing God to use us as salt and light. Because my friend, I'm telling you, the only thing that can make a lasting difference in people's lives is the Lord Jesus Christ, is the Word of God and the power of the Holy Spirit of God. And God has given us both. God has given us his Spirit and God has given us his Word. And God wants us to be building up, and God wants us to be salt and light in a dark society. So as part of being salt and light, we must pray for those that are hurting. And today, my friend, the people of India are hurting. I looked up a site today called India Today, and it said that in the last 24 hours, 3,293 people have died in the last 24 hours in the country of India. They have died from the coronavirus. Now understand, India is a vast country. It's a great subcontinent. And the has a very large population, 1.366 billion, according to the 2019 estimates. So it's a lot of people there. And my friend, God has a lot of people in India. Many, many people who have come to know Christ as their Savior, and many more who need to come to know Christ as their Savior. You'll recall God's servant, the Apostle Thomas. They call him Doubting Thomas. But church history tells us that Thomas was the one who took the gospel to India. And my friend, today in India, we have many, many brothers and sisters. And we have many more that need to come to know Christ. And they are suffering. And we need to pray for them. Then in the country of Burma, you know, recently there was a military coup in Burma. The military overthrew the newly elected, democratically elected government in India, in Burma. And so the military has gone out and killed a lot of people. It's really a bad situation in Burma as well. And we have brothers and sisters in Burma. We have some of our brothers and sisters here who are from Burma. God has given me the opportunity to work with some of them, but their families are suffering. So Asia is a hot spot today, and especially the countries of India and Burma. And I'm asking you, if you just take a few minutes to pray. If you can do anything else to help, by all means help. Anything practical you can do. You know, we are praying and asking God to send them medical supplies. They need the vaccines. They need ventilators. They need all kinds of equipment. They need personnel. And we are asking God to send those supplies in. And if you can, if you are in a situation where you can do something practical to help them, then help them. But if you can, there is something for sure that we can do. And God has called upon us as his people to pray for all people. And today I'm asking you, would you help me? Would you join me as we pray for those two suffering countries, country of India and the country of Burma? Let us pray together. Father, thank you so much. Thank you for calling men and women, boys and girls from every tribe and culture and tongue. Lord, you love all people and you care about all people. And your word says that you are not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. And we pray for a massive turning to you. We pray in the midst of this turmoil, in the midst of this suffering, in this pain in India and in Burma, that many, many would come to know Jesus as their Savior. Lord, we pray that you would send them the supplies that they need. Lord, place it upon the hearts of other countries who are in a position to help, to send them these medical supplies, to send them the vaccines, to send them this personnel. Send them, O God. And I ask you, Father, you are the God of all comfort and grace and strength. And I pray that you would comfort those that are hurting. Lord, many, many people have lost loved ones. Families have lost more than one family member. Father, I ask you, comfort and strengthen and minister to them. We pray for the country of Burma. Lord, many have been killed. Lord, many are suffering because of this military coup. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would help the people of Burma. Lord, I pray that you would speak sense into the minds or in the hearts of the military people, that they would turn over the country back to civilian rule. Be with our brothers and sisters in Burma. And be with those that have not yet come to know Christ. And in the midst of this turmoil, oh God, may many, many, many come to know Christ as their Savior. And I pray that you would help us, your people, here in the United States and all over the world, to stand up for righteousness, to stand up for godliness. Lord, that the Lord Jesus would work in our hearts and cause us to love with the love of God and cause us to care with the care that comes from the Lord Jesus Christ. Again, Father, touch the lives of the people in India. Send them help. Touch the lives of the people in Burma. Send them help. And may it, in it all, O God, may the name of our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, be glorified. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for being with us today. I ask you, wherever you are, at your home, in the privacy of your home, with your family, your church, in whatever group you are in, I ask you, really, really, take some time today and pray for the people of India and for the people of Burma. God bless you. Thank you so much for being with me today.